So how did we get from .NET Framework to .NET 6? It's a long story. .NET is 19 years old, and it's been around and gone through several different changes over the years. .NET Framework came out back in 2002, and we went through several different versions of it, and it ran all on Windows, and it ships as part of Windows. That's a rare, very cool thing. Now, we evolved and we saw other .NET versions and frameworks come along, like Silverlight and Windows Phone, right? And Xamarin, Mono, all of these .NETs. And we started seeing some compatibility challenges. How do we get them to work together so I can write my code once and run it on all these different places? And we had some ideas of how to do that, but we wanted to reboot and really have a .NET that was focused on building things for the cloud faster and better. So, we introduced .NET Core, and with .NET Core, we started with capabilities for ASP.NET Core and building console applications. After two or three versions of that, we said, you know what, there's some things there for desktop developers in .NET Framework that we should get into this new, faster, smaller framework. So we brought WPF and WinForms into .NET Core, starting with .NET Core 3. Now, how do we get stuff back and forth then from .NET Core and .NET Framework? We introduced .NET Standard that would allow you to build applications that reference shared libraries that have a standard contract level. As we went into .NET 5 and now .NET 6, we need to bring those together and we wanted to ship one unified framework. So we no longer need .NET Standard. We can target just .NET 6, build our application, and everything is in one framework, one version, and you can ship that today.